Hello?
Is this suicide hotline?
Yes. My name is Joe. What's yours?
Jean-Michel.
Jean-Michel. What's that, French?
Haitian.
I remember as a teenager in 1985 listening to Jean-Michel Basquiat's inspiring story and how fast it was already beginning to turn in the art world. I was just feeling and admiring the style, the creativity that was coming from a prodigious and self-taught artist with so much courage and perseverance. Basquiat is one of the most celebrated artists of his generation, combining techniques with so much energy and creating a powerful tension between opposing aesthetic forces. His expression and knowledge, control, spontaneity, savagery, urbanity, and commentary on the locus of terror and misgiving in a racist society. Major exhibitions in London, Paris, New York City, and Hong Kong in the last couple of years have brought the late artist's work to a new generation, while demand among art collectors stayed insatiable. Research done by ArtNet shows that 77% of all auction sales for African American over the last decade was Basquiat. In May 2016, one of his head paintings sold for $57.3 million. The following year, Entitled, a Basquiat from 1982, was sold for $110.5 million at Sotheby's, setting a record for an American artist. Basquiat not only left 800 paintings, but also thousands of drawings who constitute his legacy and inspiration for the world. So what can we learn from Basquiat today? The widening of our gaze beyond traditional sources of inspiration can lead to discoveries, while spending time on looking at art because it's not the same than just scrolling through it. It is the importance of showing up for your work because it can't be granted.
I think there's a lot of people that are neglected in art. I don't know if because if it's who made the paintings or what, but I don't know. I know black people are never really portrayed realistically in. Not even portrayed in modern art enough.